Hi guys. Hey, I just had a friend ask me how to make a carved out heart on a tree. I looked around and I couldn't really find anything simple, so I just thought I would make a quick tutorial because I know I have done this before. So I found my file that I had made before and I just thought I'd show you real quick how to do this. This is what we're looking at, and I'm going to zoom in here so you can see it. Basically, to start out, you're going to make the person's name. I've got this font here, Boopy, and I don't know where I got it, but as you can see, it just looks like some type of handwriting. I'm going to increase this. And I got capitals, plus sign, and Bobby. I need to separate this a little bit, so I'm going to come over to my character. I'm going to separate it. Got to get everything. Put 50. And then reduce it. I'm going to change the color so we can see this better. At least for starters, we'll have it at this. We'll change it later. This width. I don't want it quite that far apart. Okay, so that is how we make the text. Then to make the heart, I'm going to come to my shape tool, custom shape tool, come to my shapes, and I'm going to come over here to shape, and I'm going to go to the heart. Now I come over here, and I make a heart, however I want it to look. I'm going to put it over here. I'm going to put it underneath their names. Press enter to get it to take. I'm going to put it okay. Now I'm going to double click it and come over to stroke. We're going to increase the stroke to about the same width as the text. Come up here to blending options, change the fill opacity to 0. Okay, so now we have our basic setup. I don't like to destroy layers without being sure, so I'm going to group them, Control G, then I'm going to duplicate them, turn one off, so this is my backup in case I decide to change anything. Come up here, and I'm going to rasterize this layer. Now it's flat, so I can't change that one, but I still have the backup. I can position this where I want it, so I can come over here and angle it and bring it to the right position and make it smaller. I'm pressing shift so it doesn't become distorted. Say I want it right here where the old one was. Let's go ahead and turn this one off for now or move it out of the way. Decide what color I want it. I'm going to come over to this little half moon, half circle filled in, and I'm going to press Alt, and while Alt is pressed down, I'm going to come to solid color, and it's going to say, do I want to create a clipping mask with the previous layer? And I'm going to say yes. So now it's clipped with this little arrow, so it's only going to change the color of the heart. So then I'm going to choose a color. I can choose a color from my picture if I want. Okay, I like that one. I'm going to merge those layers. So now I've changed the color. So now if I want to add effects to this, I basically have already done this over here. So I'm going to put this on my free area of my website. So you can download this and you can click copy layer style. You can bring it over to yours, and this is kind of a shortcut. You can click paste layer style. So now you've got an embossed project. This one is in an overlay mode of linear burn. I might want to increase some of my bevel here because It looks a little bit like I might want it deeper. So I'm going to come over to this. I'm going to make it a little bit deeper. But if you wanted to do this from scratch, what you would need to do is you will double click this layer and you'll get these choices. And you'll want bevel and emboss checkmarked. And you'll want emboss chisel soft with a depth that is around 42 depending on your size of your photo. I have a size here of 4. I could increase it or decrease it. This is a, I have global light on, which you can mess with that and change it. Screen 75, multiply 75, which is the default. So then contour, I have chosen this contour. So you can play around with these and choose which contour you want for your emboss. Then I have inner shadow on multiply with a distance of 4 and 4. And I have inner glow, which is, let's see what that looks like off. It doesn't make a huge difference. So I don't know if you even want to mess with that one, but it is on there. Inner shadow, as I can see here, is not making a huge difference either. The bevel and emboss is the main one with contour. But it, you know, it looks like I made this stroke a little bit bigger in my original, which probably helped. That could be enough if you didn't want to do, you know, spend a ton of time on this. If you do want to spend a little extra time and you want to make it look like it really belongs, then I recommend a displacement map. What you do is you come over to your channels and you choose the channel. I'm going to turn these off for this. You choose the channel that has the most texture to it. And I would say this one has the most. So I will duplicate the channel and ask me if I want to make a new document, which I do. And I'm going to name it Displaced Wood. And then I'm going to save it, File, Save As. And I did this before, but I'm going to call it Displaced Wood. Then I come over to my original and I turn this on. I'm going to come to, I'm actually going to turn this off for right now. And I'm going to come to Filter, Distort, Displace. And I have it set to 10 and 10, and that's fine because I can add more if I want to. And I'm going to say okay, and then I need to choose my displaced wood file that I just created, and it immediately displaces it. It looks like it put it a little bit over her dress, so that would be something that we would need to fix. Then you can turn back on your effects and you can see what it looks like if you like it. You can add another one if you want. You can just come to Filter and then it'll be your first choice if you already did it, and you can hit Displace again. As far as her dress being covered, I could just add a mask and come over here to a brush, increase the size of my brush. My cap lock is on, so it wasn't showing. Turn this to black, and I can maybe make this a little bit harder. And I can just carefully make my brush a little bit different. And then if I got too much, I can switch it back and bring this back in. So there you go. That is how you make a heart carved out of a barn. So I hope you enjoyed it. You can add this exact same effect to a tree or anything that you wanted to add carving to. Enjoy.